Zambia is a landlocked country in central sub-Saharan Africa. The people of Zambia face many of the same challenges that others experience in this region of the world, notably a lack of education, poor health, and extreme poverty. Chindwin Home Based Care Savings and Loans Association is a small but growing group of concerned individuals that have the shared goal of improving the well-being of the people in a neighborhood called Chindwin, located on the outskirts of Kabwe, the capital city of Central Province Zambia. We have reached our destination. Welcome to Chindwin. The mid-1990s were a dire time in Kabwe. HIV/AIDS had been gaining momentum for some time, facilitated by widespread ignorance, stigma, and denial. As parents died, grandparents took on the responsibility of stretching their meager resources to care for the growing population of orphaned children. This was not an easy task. As if that weren't enough, the economy in Zambia was also dying. Almost overnight, the region's copper mines halted to a stop as the international price of copper plummeted. This economic shock snowballed, leading to the bankruptcy of textile factories, zinc and lead mines, and the privatization and downsizing of Zambian Railways. The citizens of Kabwe were devastated. This is the Zambia-China Mulungushi textile factory. Upon its closing, hundreds of workers lost their jobs and their livelihoods. It was during these crises that a handful of caregivers decided to organize Chindwin Home Based Care. These caregivers volunteered their time and resources to care for the overwhelming number of individuals crippled and housebound because of AIDS. These efforts operated with little government support during a time when the price of antiretroviral medication was exorbitant and beyond the means of nearly all Zambians. After a few years of fighting an uphill battle, some of the caregivers decided to develop a microcredit program whereby caregivers could invest in a savings fund. The fund acted as a source for caregivers to secure loans and as an investment opportunity whereby caregiver contributions would be repaid with a percentage of the interest payments. Furthermore, the remaining interest would be earmarked to the newly formed Chindwin Home-Based Care Savings and Loans Association, who used these funds to support community projects. One of Chindwin Home-Based Care Savings and Loans Association's primary activities has been to expand their microcredit program to include members of the community. Currently, the program provides loans to 10 women's groups, including over 250 women. The loans provided function as vital startup capital to empower women in entrepreneurial activities. Some of the women now have their own shops, others offer tailoring services, and others have purchased seed to grow and sell fruits and vegetables. Kaputula Women's Group No. 2 is conducting their weekly meeting where some members are contributing funds to their savings accounts and other members are obtaining loans. Following is a video of one of the women's groups taking part in Africa's favorite pastime, song and dance. Food insecurity is a significant problem in Zambia. Most families depend on their maize crops for food. This can become a problem, especially as families don't normally practice crop rotation and can't afford industrial fertilizers. As a result, the nutrients in the soil become depleted, crop yields decrease, and families can go hungry. With the assistance of Color Me In, a United States-based nonprofit organization, Chindwin Home-Based Care Savings and Loans Association has created a tree planting program. Training sessions have been organized with community leaders to teach them how to plant and care for a green manure tree called Cespania cespan. The leaves of this tree fall to the ground, enriching the soil and stimulating crop growth. Here you can see the soil-enriching trees that have been planted in Kapotula Women's Group No. 1's sugarcane fields. This is the Natuseko Community Basic School. With minimal government funding, the school was financed and constructed by families living in the Natuseko area of Chindwin. Chindwin Home Based Care Savings and Loans Association has partnered with the Natuseko School with the intentions of providing school supplies and funding to cover the school's operational expenses. Although antiretroviral medication is now allowing HIV-infected individuals to live long, productive lives, in years past when medication coverage was inadequate, HIV was truly a death sentence. When parents died, children were left to fend for themselves. Chindwin has an extraordinarily high number of orphans and vulnerable children. Currently, Chindwin Home-Based Care Savings and Loans Association is in the process of developing a child sponsorship program. This program will provide financial assistance to women caring for orphans and vulnerable children. This is just a glimpse into the developments of the program and the aspirations of a young child. Chindwin Home-Based Care Savings and Loans Association has lofty aspirations but is limited by considerable resource constraints. The association operates as a volunteer, not-for-profit organization with only one paid staff member. In order to empower more individuals living in the Chindwin area to gain access to education, food security, and to escape poverty, more funding will be required. Chindwin Home-Based Care Savings and Loans Association is requesting donations and welcomes discussion with any potential funders. Please contact Wilson Ngosa, the Chindwin Home-Based Care Savings and Loans Association Program Manager, at the supplied email address. Thank you.